This is the jam right here. This is race music. Sup guys, I'm Oliver Aston, and today we got another Klassicz for you, and we are checking out Top Gear for the Super Nintendo from 1992. In case you couldn't tell by that helpful little graphic I now added to the corner. This is one of the first racing games I ever experienced. Back in the day, me and my dad used to play this one all the time. I don't know if I can really say back in the day, considering I was probably only 4 or 5, but still. Wonderful game. Still remember the music to this day, of course. Of course I'm playing it again, but it's burned into my memory. And this is the Las Vegas track, which I have failed on countless times. At least, you know, back when I was younger. Of course, I'm still pretty bad now. One thing I never understood about this game was why it was always in split screen. Even when, this is me playing alone right here, and you always have a computer or something with you. Which is, you know, okay. You've always got the option of screen looking, I suppose. We are now racing on the Los Angeles track in the game. And as you can probably figure it out right now, this game is fantastic for multiplayer. It's got all that fantastic 16-bit 3D, but not real 3D glory. And it does have a fairly good sense of speed for a game from 1992. I can still, you know, look back and remember having, you know, just really fond memories with this game. And, you know, it's held up relatively well. And as you can see, I am losing my fuel. And pretty soon, you're actually going to see me run out, which is wonderful. Because I am terrible at the game and I'm terrible at managing my gears. I should probably never drive stick. Oh, and there we go. I think we're just going to switch back to some Las Vegas footage where I wasn't losing so bad. Or was I? Suffice to say, if you're looking for a 16-bit racer, then you may want to check out Top Gear. It's got, you know, a bit more strategy to it with the shifting of the gears, and the AI on the cars can actually be a bit difficult to get by, even on amateur. Of course, maybe it's just because I'm a crappy player, I have no idea. But I definitely recommend checking it out if you are in the market for a 16-bit racer. It's fairly cheap these days to pick up for the Super Nintendo. And yeah, give it a go. It's a pretty fun game, great if you've got a buddy to play with, and yeah, what more can I really say? I highly recommend it, check it out if you get a chance, and be sure to rate, comment, and subscribe. This is Ollie, signing off.